Over our country's history, we know that public health crises tend to get a lot of attention, whether we're talking about the polio crisis earlier in the 1900s, or even recently now the opioid crisis. I have read a lot of recent material that gun violence is also considered a public health crisis. Is this something that your department is looking at from the health department, and have you allocated any funding towards addressing gun violence specifically as a public health crisis?
So certainly, violent injury, death is something that the department looks at and takes incredibly seriously. I think a really important piece of that from the public health perspective is to make sure that our system is ready to respond to crises like we've seen recently. And so we have an excellent public health preparedness bureau that works hand in hand with hospital system and EMS providers so that we can be sure that in light of tragedies that we are ready to respond and the health system is ready to respond and take care of individuals who have been injured as a result of a violent act. I think we've seen from some of the reports that have come out from Florida about how that training and preparedness better prepared them to respond. And so we do that now, and we are taking a fresh look about making sure that we're doing that in the most robust way so that the health system can be prepared to respond.
And if I may clarify, I'm not just referring to mass shootings, but daily gun violence that occurs throughout this Commonwealth, particularly in urban cities, urban centers. How, what are we doing to respond to those concerns that happen in those communities where you have trauma, and from young children throughout, dealing with trauma from daily gun violence in our communities? And my concern is that when we address crises and we put the resources behind them, we find solutions. If we don't put the resources behind issues like gun violence and acknowledge that to be an actual public health crisis, then we will not address the solution over time. Mm-hmm.
And I think highlighting the importance of the impact of the trauma that violent injury can cause, and certainly other experiences, particularly young people that have experience, and then that impact that can have on their long-term health outcomes is something that from public health we are concerned about and watching. And making sure that when we work with healthcare systems and providers, and that care is trauma informed and can be responsive to those needs, because we certainly know in the department that individuals' health outcomes can be a manifestation of where they live and how their daily life goes. A particular initiative that we're working on related to that is called Public Health 3.0, which is an initiative that was originally developed by Health and Human Services, but it is working hand in hand with communities to build health into daily life. So over the past year, we've engaged over 374 stakeholders and having those really important conversations around what are the health drivers in your community and how can we be partners in the department to respond in really that effort to prevent disease, that concept of health promotion and disease prevention, rather than the responsive aspect that is talked about much more in health when we're caring for people after they've become sick or injured.
And a follow-up question to a separate issue. Mm-hmm. About a year ago, we identified a certain corridor in North Philadelphia as a health empowerment zone between, I believe, Hahnemann Hospital, Temple Hospital, and Einstein Hospital. And we looked at a certain number, a group of factors, number of emergency visits and all of other sort of health factor indicators. Parts of that includes my district. What haven't really heard much following that. What resources have been put behind the health empowerment zone, and what are the plans going forward?
Sure. So that's an initiative that I'm familiar with, but am not the expert on. So that a lot of those efforts have been led by Secretary Miller in the Department of Human Services, and I know it remains to be an initiative and priority that they are looking at and working on. But I do encourage you to get more details during that meeting.
Thank you. I have no further questions.
Thank you.